We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Minnesota Vikings and the Los Angeles Rams. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. What a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 3-yard line.
And hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
There goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
If you do read man covers, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people.
Fresh set of downs here. Second down, just 1 yard to go. Nickel formation here defensively.
Short yardage situations, you'll see the linebackers step up into the gaps, what we call mugging the line of scrimmage, to make sure they take away all spaces and creases. That one worked really well for them.
Only needed a yard, instead went backwards. So the opening drive for them here on their home turf is a field goal.
And that's the way you want to get things started. Your stadium, your crowd, you've got the ball, put points on the board first, and let everyone start to celebrate.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. Their quarterback standing 6'3". Down. And the catch made, it's Tyler Boyd. moves the chains. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. When the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. And then moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Shift together here from the D-line. Back to throw now on second and 10. Throw left side complete. It's Boyd. Touchdown, Vikings! Tyler Boyd, his second touchdown on the season. And the Vikings have taken a first quarter lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in big sky country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
This one taken from the seven. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Offense, they work their way back on the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They did a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see. Six on the board here. We'll see. That throw good for four. It's second down. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down.
Leopard! No. Check! Patriots! Patriots! Green 39! Leopard! Leopard! Back it's gone! Philly! Green 39! Detroit! Over!
From the gun, Brock. Throw right sentence into the hands of his tight end, Everett. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. We've seen quite a bit of a short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to keep up, start to press your receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some more quick shots down the field.
And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to a 40-yard line. That good for 22 first down.
That part, I have to say, they caught him in the right defense there. Nichols set, fifth defensive back on the field, and they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DBs like you, they want the interception. They're not as worried about the running play, right?
Not at all. I still remember being in school, and one of my offensive line teammates used to say, boy, I'd love to come down here and hit you little people.
Good run there.
Detroit!
Throwing on first down. Brock. That's right underneath for Boyd. Oh, now he blows him over. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down. Just the first quarter, the tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season-open opponent.
Back live now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Rams with a football to get us going. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10.
That's what I thought about what my coaches have told me in the past. The biggest teaching point get your head around, locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Back to the ground game here. Gurley. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
Do you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down, ladies and gentlemen. We have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Trying to hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet. Get no rack yardage.
They've done a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. So it's an empty trip downfield there as they get a missed field goal on fourth down.
And I didn't see anything in the setup. It's a good snap, good hold.
Yep.
He just pushed it, and that one never wanted to come back.
Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11.
Let's go! Green 39!
Again, it's Cook. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. He lost two there, and it's third down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to save that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. Fake. They'll look to throw. He's got his man, Boyd. Tyler Boyd, he's gonna go. Touchdown, Vikings. Tyler Boyd, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Vikings find a way to stretch their lead. Now he's having a nice little first half here, Parker.
It's a first half that leaves us in. Still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. Let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out? With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick-hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
Let's go! Detroit! Detroit! Watch it now. Look at 56.
Off play action. Brock. Austin's got it. Left side. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
chance to play here in the first half. We're back to the City of Angels after this timeout. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Larry Ridley in Orlando with our EA Sports halftime report.
The ones running around the NFL nowadays. Makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? What a really nice game right there. First down for them. Ends up a nice second down for them.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. And now prior to second one, we're going to get a timeout. They'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. The Rams on third down. Just one for three thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one.
Patriots! 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 All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Lucky 99, Philly. Here we go. No. Check. Patriots! Patriots! No. Check. Patriots!
Back to throw. Intercepted. Xavier Rhodes with a pick. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys were picking it up. They're not saying that. What word are they using? It's asking. That means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say asking.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as those guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession. Now.
And nearly picked off there. Almost intercepted. Instead, second down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Second down here after the incomplete pass. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now we see Sammy Watkins getting ready to go again on offense. With them losing. losing here in the second quarter and his limited productivity so far, you'd have to think they're going to try to look to him a little bit more, right?
I would guess you would start to see maybe some quick screens, some hitches, anything to get the ball in his hands quickly and let him try and do some damage after the catch. Or maybe just flip some formations and keep him isolated where it's more of a one-on-one route and get the ball to him.
I'll say just four verts, right?
Hey, why not four verts? One of the best routes in football. Hard to cover each guy all the way along the route.
So far, just one catch for him. From the out route, incomplete. It's Austin.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march up another 15 against your squad.
Second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. It'll come with 36 ticks to go. Half number one. The Rams on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third down and 12. One's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Encroachment defense.
A little eager there coming in from his outside linebacker position.
You think the hard count got him there? Yeah, maybe an extra hard count and an extra emphasis on it. Got him to jump and then picked up five.
Now, here we go.
Between playing man and playing zone. When you're a man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position.
Check Patriot! Let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90! Watch it now, Barney! Barney!
Trying to
throw there, partner. I mean, he's already thrown two interceptions here in the first half. I don't know if you want to keep throwing up 50-50 balls and you've had that kind of lack of success.
Yeah, absolutely. Very well could have been a third interception in half number one.
No. Check. Patriot. Here we go now. Boo 90. Boo 90. No. Check. Patriot. Over.
Back to the air on second down. Chance to return this one. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on. Here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. But he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch. And most offenses make a living off of yards after catches. Hidden yards, it may not go into the
field. The Rams got it. They bring him down. DeMarcus Lawrence. In there to get him for a 5. And I know it seems like we say this a lot in broadcast booths, but a quarterback can hold on to the football too long in these situations. I think he did right there.
Oh, I agree with you totally. Sometimes you have to understand situations. Get rid of the football. Save some yardage to make it less to gain for the next down. Instead, he was so hyped on ball security, he held on to it and took a big sack.
Has moved the ball. He hasn't been needed till here in the third. And he was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Rams will go on offense here with a 1st and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half? Because that's exactly what they're trained on. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker board?
Yeah, those two.
Oh, look at 56. Watch it.
Gurley again here on 1st down. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Not much happening there on 1st down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
2nd down following the run.
Pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. On 3rd down, Brock. And this is caught by Lockett.
inside. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for fourth down.
A short gain that doesn't get them the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. Side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against them.
Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again.
Well, they're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shot of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So he's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
And he'll get them a little space here up to the 5-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
On second down, Cook, and an alley to run. And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on third down?
The way things have gone in this one, the running game's been something of an afterthought, and that's not been too bad for them, has it?
Yeah, the offensive returns have been good, but I guess we figured he and the ground game would be a bit more involved.
They'll look to throw here. He's going deep for Brown. And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Vikings. John Brown, 92 yards. And this Viking offense is running away with this one.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. I mean, he's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in a masterclass right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
4 touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like this is going to be a completion.
Back now in Los Angeles. Or the fourth quarter will begin with a kickoff following the score on the final play of the third quarter. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
No doubt we're talking about offense right here. The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it. So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive. See it all over the place, but what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
Throwing on first down, Brock. Oh, dropped it, and that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Here we go. Over.
To throw again. Brock. Looking again for Watkins, and this time that's complete. gets this inside the 35-yard line. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield to a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back, those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to lead to a 3rd and 12.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really, at the point of attack, the offensive line is just getting pushed around. I think now, as a play caller, you got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe you keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence, because you can't abandon them.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. He'll take it all the way up to the 40-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Let's go!
They start the drive with Cook, and he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time. And that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage. Use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind that it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it, because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
The Vikings on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Time for a break. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a 3rd down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. Hand off comes to Cook. It's a 6-yard pickup, but still a few chain lengths short, it appears, with 4th down coming up. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that, and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team, and we were losing late in a game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build.
Just something to build on, get it done, and maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Now whistles come in. Getting a timeout here by the offense as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. Just over a minute to go in the game.
Check. Patriot. Blue line. Watch it now, Barney. Here we go now.
offense lining up first and 10. So cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. It took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
Of a good 10 yards.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
For the fourth time today.